Frank Romano, head coach here at Notre Dame College. Coach Romano, you guys are a new program, I believe, in your third year of existence.
Third year, yep.
Okay,
yep.
You guys competed against the Purdue Boilermakers today. You guys got two falls.
Yep.
Talk about the match, man.
Well, I thought it was a pretty good match. I thought in one instance, we won three matches, two falls. In Strong's match, I thought it was a real fast call on the back points. If they wouldn't have given him those two, we'd have won that match. And then Cabala had that one position where he had to take that. We might have won that match, too. So I felt pretty good about the meet. I thought we were only totally outmanned at 84. That was about the only match that we really got, you know, just they had a better guy, obviously. But other than that, we had a real good crowd. It was really great for our program. And I was really glad that Purdue could make it.
Okay, so you guys are NAIA.
NAIA,
and you wrestled so far. You've had two Big Ten opponents.
Yeah, we wrestled Ohio State in a duel in Columbus. We had a big crowd there. We lost the match, but we had a pretty good fight with them, and we had Purdue this year. And then we also are going to be at the NAIA National Duels in 2 weeks out in Northern Iowa.
Okay,
the NAIA teams.
Oh, with the NAIA, okay.
Yeah, strictly NAIA.
Okay, what are you guys ranked in the NAIA polls?
Well, Fickle, who runs for the Wrestling USA, ranked us third. The coaches ranked us ninth. We were ranked one time seventh, so we've been in the top 10 most of the year. The highest is third.
How many total teams competing, coach?
I think we're about 38 to 40 now. There's been a couple additions last year, between 38 and 40, I think, in the country.
Okay, coach. Yeah. You guys, you wrestled Mount Union this year.
Yeah, we wrestled Mount Union.
Okay, are there going to be in Ohio State, obviously?
Yeah.
Will there be an OU? Will there be
in
the future?
In the schedule next year, which I'll probably do in the spring, I'm going to try to contact as many people as I can to see, you know, what kind of schedule we could put together. We're independent, we're not in the league, so we really can branch out and do almost anything we want as long as people want to compete against us. So.
Okay, coach, what's the biggest rule that you guys have to follow in the NAIA, would you say?
I mean academically or athletically?
Athletically.
Probably athletically, you know, there's a date limitation, there's a scholarship limitation, which is 8. And those two things are huge. And
but that 8's different than the 9.9.
Yeah, that's a good question. 8 is totally different. Because regardless of how much money you have out, the only money that counts against your 8 is if a guy steps on the mat and actually wrestles a varsity match. So you might have more than 8 grants out, but you have to watch and make sure that the people that you send out, their money counts and only their money. So as soon as you send somebody out to participate in a match, that's when the money counts. So you have to keep track of that, which we do.
So you could have 16 guys on full rides as long as it's no more than 8 to wrestle.
Theoretically, you probably wouldn't have that, but theoretically you could have a lot of people and a lot of money, yeah. Theoretically.
Okay, coach. After the NAIA duels, when will your season conclude then?
We have the we go to the Edinburgh Open. We wrestle Seton Hill. We wrestle in the Mount St. Joe's duels down in Cincinnati. I think Indianapolis is there. We have a triple duel in Campbellsville, and then the NAIA qualifier is at Lindenwood, and you have to qualify.
New Jersey.
No, Lindenwood, Missouri.
Lindenwood
University in Missouri.
Okay, my bad.
It's in St. Charles.
Okay.
And it's an NAIA school.
How many qualifiers can you take, coach?
Four. The top four in each weight class qualifier are the qualifier, but the maximum a team could take is 12. 12 is the magic number. You could have 2 in 6 weight classes. You could have all 10 weight classes, one guy and two guys in 2 different weight classes. The magic number is 12.
So you can't have 3 qualifiers in
a weight class. No, you can't have 3 qualifiers in any weight class. 2 maximum, and then also 12 is the magic number.
So a lot more opportunity,
yes.
Definitely, at the NAIA
yes.
level.
A lot more opportunity. And if you have 2 really good guys at the same weight, they can both score. They're all counters. So if you get 12 guys at the national tournament, regardless of what weights, no more than 2 to weight class, they all score.
Okay.
And everybody has the same option, so
okay.
It's fair.
So one last thing. I noticed looking up and down the lineup,
yes.
A lot of D1 talent. How are you getting those guys to come in?
I got some good assistants that know how to recruit. they really do a great job, and they're on top of everything, and they know the state, and they know who's doing where and who's coming out and who's making it and who's not making it, and it's really worked. It's really worked. But I give them a tremendous amount of credit. Tremendous amount of credit. I was an assistant for a long time, so I know what they do. It's hard work.
Okay, anything else you got for the people about Notre Dame College?
I'm just real happy that we had a great crowd, and I think our kids appreciated it, and we had a good row with Purdue, and I think that they thought that they were in a wrestling match, which is a good thing.
All right, coach. Head coach for the Notre Dame College Falcons, Frank Romano. Coach Romano, good luck at the national duels.
Thanks,
and
sir.
The rest of the season.
I appreciate that. It's great you could be here. Really great.
No problem, coach. Anything for you.